Why do you use Nielsen level diagrams, not Sachs-Wolfe diagrams? And why did not include Virchow-Dekalkov deformation?
For BCS model, in the BCS model, the single particle level and single particle angular momentum entered, and I used the single particle from the Nielsen. Because we have the Nielsen code and we use this code. But I don't use the Wood-Sachson potential. I don't test.
Ah, sorry. And I see that Virchow-Dekalkov deformation is not included. That is important deformation for the this region of nuclei.
I use the deformation in Nielsen potential.
You included quadrupole deformation, but important also to include hexadecapole deformation.
I don't know.
Прощение, можно по-русски, вы что хотели сказать? Я попробую перевести.
Так я вроде правильно перевел?
По-моему, все понятно.
Гексадекакольная деформация. Альфа-4.
Ну, скажите ему просто чётче тогда. Он просто не слышит, не слышит.
Вы смотрите не микрофон.
Скажите микрофон, ему не слышит.
Держать?
Нет.
Где микрофон?
My question is about why did not you include did not include the hexadecapole deformation for this nuclei? Because that is important feature of this nuclei.
I have considered the deformation in the Nielsen potential.
But another deformation, hexadecapole deformation, is not zero.
Oh, I don't use. But the experimental data, oral agreement between experimental and theoretical data are satisfactory.
But result is, but result depends on the quality of level scheme in reality. Because many people do this before. Me, Ignatiuk, Atasis, Malov, I don't see what is difference with other calculations.
Can you give compare with another calculation? Your result with calculation another.
Or is that compared with experimental data by the Oslo group? I don't compare with other experimental data or other theoretical data.
How that critical temperature can be observed and then compared with your results?
In step two, we set the delta pairing gap equal zero and find the critical temperature. The critical temperature for neutron system separately and the critical temperature for proton system. And the average of critical temperature for proton and neutron system is the total critical temperature.
My question is how critical temperature can be observed? From which data are used for comparison, for calculated and observable critical temperature?
I have been determined the critical temperature. The pairing of at zero temperature, we use the pairing of at critical zero temperature in atomic mass evaluation, and we use the BCS equation for pairing gap. Then the I set the delta equal zero, and we find the critical temperature. But after the critical temperature, the equation is simple, and we use the we have no pairing gap, but it isn't. It no physical, but the result a slightly difference from theoretical.